Today we are going to discuss about the verification of law of conservation of mass during chemical reaction. We know during chemical reaction, total mass of reactant is equal to total mass of product. So how experimentally we can verify it? See here what apparatus I have taken. I have taken test tube, conical flask, one balance. Chemical I have taken sodium chloride and silver nitrate. We know when silver nitrate aqueous solution mixed with sodium chloride aqueous solution, what happen? Sodium nitrate is formed and there is precipitation of silver chloride. So silver nitrate mean AgNO3 aqueous solution mixed with sodium chloride mean NaCl. What they are forming is solution of sodium nitrate and white color precipitation of AgCl, that is sodium chloride. See here, sodium chloride solution we have taken in a conical flask here, and sodium nitrate solution I have taken in a test tube. This is test tube, see here, in test tube, and very carefully I have kept this sodium nitrate solution test tube inside the conical flask, and what have airtight, we have taken a rubber cork here, and airtight rubber cork we have fixed it, and weight these full conical flask with sodium nitrate solution. See here what is weight has come, 300.23 gram weight has come. After that I have mixed this test tube by making it reverse direction. What happened? This sodium nitrate solution is mixed with sodium chloride. Here this we have mixed, we have seen they are forming here, they are forming sodium nitrate and a white color precipitation of this white color precipitation. See here, this is of sodium chloride. After performing the chemical reaction, again I have measured this weight of this conical flask with test tube. We have seen it again come 300.23 gram. See here, before the chemical reaction, total mass of reactant is 3.23 gram. This is AgNO3 plus NaCl. And after the reaction, total mass of product mean white color precipitation of AgCl and NaNO3 sodium nitrate. This total again we have measured. This is 300.23 gram. So by this apparatus or by this experiment, we can see that total mass of reactant is equal to total mass of product, or we can say the law of conservation of mass is taking place during the chemical reaction. Okay, we are going to start balancing a chemical reaction. In balancing chemical reaction, firstly we are writing the chemical equation in symbolic form. After that we will see the number of atoms present in reactant and number of atoms present in product, and we are balancing each atom both side. We have seen there the total mass is conserved during the chemical reaction. If mass is conserved, so 100% what happened? Total number of atoms present in reactants is equal to total number of present in product. So in balancing, what we have to do, total number of each atom in reactant should be equals to total number of atom in product. See here, sodium reacted with water. Sodium hydroxide they are formed and hydrogen gas is evolved. Balance this chemical reaction, write chemical equation and balance this. So firstly, write in symbolic form.
sodium reacted with water, sodium hydroxide NaOH and hydrogen gas U. Firstly, what we have to do? Write each and every atom in reactant and product. See, element reactant, the number of elements in reactant, number of elements write down in product. How many elements is here? You can see one is sodium. Number of sodium in reactants, here one, here also one. Second, you can see hydrogen is here. Number of atoms H2, so this is 2. Here you can see in NaOH 1 hydrogen is there, in H2 2 hydrogen, total number of hydrogen is 3. If you see oxygen, oxygen is number of oxygen in reactants, that is in H2O1. If you see in product NaOH, here is 1. To see here, sodium 1, hydrogen here 2, here 3, oxygen 1. So sodium and oxygen is balanced, but if you see hydrogen, this will be unbalanced. This here 2, this here 3. Firstly, we are going to balance hydrogen. How will you balance the hydrogen? Hydrogen ko kaise balance karenge? Because in balancing the equation, we can multiply the total number of moles. We can take 2 moles, 3 moles. We can multiply a term by any integer or any number. To see here, if you want to balance hydrogen, so here hydrogen is 3, here hydrogen is 2. So one method, if I will multiply here 2, then what happen? This will become 2 2's are 4 and here 3. So we have to multiply by this NaOH H by 2. So firstly, we will multiply this by 2. I multiplied this water by 2. What happen? This becomes 2 2's are 4. Number of hydrogen becomes 4. But also you can see oxygen. Oxygen also multiplied by 2, so this will becomes 2. This becomes 4, this is 3. They are still unbalanced. What we have to do? We have to multiply by this sodium hydroxide to balance the hydrogen. This is 2. Here you will see 2 ones are 2. So this will become 2 plus 2. This will become 4. Here, see, about the oxygen, sodium also double, they are become 2, hydrogen, oxygen also becomes 2, 1's are 2. People see, hydrogen 4, 4, oxygen 4, 4, only one thing is unbalanced, product sodium is 2, here sodium is 1, we can multiply this sodium by 2, so this will, this sodium multiplied by 2. This will also becomes 2. In this equation you can see sodium 2 2, hydrogen 4 4, oxygen 2 2. Again I will see from here 2 sodium, 2 sodium. Number of hydrogen 2 2's are 4. Here 2 hydrogen, 2 hydrogen, 2 plus 2 4. Oxygen 2 1's are 2, here 2 1's are 2. So you can say the number of atoms of each element, sodium, hydrogen, oxygen, both are same in left hand side, that is reactant, and also in right hand side, that is product. One more reaction I have taken. Sodium hydroxide reacted with sulfuric acid. They are forming sodium sulfate and water. Write down the chemical formula. Sodium hydroxide NaOH plus H2SO4. This is sulfuric acid. They are forming sodium sulfate Na2SO4 plus H2O, water. What are the elements? Sodium, hydrogen, oxygen, and one is sulfur. Four elements in left hand side and right hand side. In reactant, how many sodium are there? Count here. This is one. Here, this is two. Hydrogen, one and two. How many hydrogen? Three. Here, hydrogen is two. Oxygen, 1 plus 4, 5, here 4 plus 1, 5, sulfur, 1 and 1, you will see, yes, sodium is unbalanced, hydrogen is also unbalanced. See here, if we are balancing the sodium, 1, 2, we have to multiply this sodium reactant, sodium of reactant by 2, so here multiply by 2. So sodium is with sodium hydroxide, we have to multiply here 2, I have multiplied, what happened, 2 ones are 2, but you see, oxygen and hydrogen also they are multiplied, here hydrogen multiplied, the 2 ones are 2, this hydrogen becomes 2. And all oxygen also becomes 2. So what will be the new? 2 plus 2, they are becoming 4. 2 plus 4, they are becoming 6. So see here, sodium is balanced, but hydrogen 4, 2, oxygen 6, 5. We are going to balance the hydrogen. Hydrogen is 4. Here hydrogen is 2. Here hydrogen is with water. What we have to do, if we are multiplying this 2, so they are also become 2 to the 4th, I have multiplied 2 water molecule. This water molecule 2 to the hydrogen becomes 4, but oxygen also become 2 and the 2. Here oxygen is 1, they are becoming 2 and the 2, so 4 plus 2, that becomes 6. Compare sodium 2-2, hydrogen 4-4, oxygen 6-6, sulfur 1-1. We can see all elements present in the reactant is equal to present in product. To see, here also you can see 2 sodium, oxygen 2 plus 4, 6. Oxygen 2 plus 4, 6. Here 4, 2 1 2, 4 plus 2, 6, 4 plus 2, 6. Here hydrogen 2 1 ja 2 plus 2 4, here 2 2 ja 4, and last sulfur, here sulfur is 1, so you can see this is the balanced reaction. When ethane burns in oxygen, carbon dioxide and water is produced. Write the chemical equation and balance it. See here, ethene reacted with oxygen, they are forming carbon dioxide and water. Write in symbolic form, ethene is what? C2H6, oxygen, O2, they are forming carbon dioxide and water. See here, how many elements are there? Carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. Write down the elements, carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. How many carbons are there? Here 2 carbons you have written, here 2. In product 1 carbon you have written 1. Here see hydrogen, how many hydrogen are there? 6. Hydrogen here 2, you have written 2. Oxygen, see here oxygen is 2 and here oxygen 2 and 1. So 2 plus 1, that is 3. Okay, see here. Carbon balanced? No. 2-1. Hydrogen balanced? No. oxygen balanced. What we have to do? Firstly, we can take any. So remember one thing. You will take that element which are in multiple form, which are present in many more atoms. जो ज्यादा एटम्स में प्रेजेंट हो उनको ही पहले बैलेंस करते हैं. दैट विल बी गुड. एक्चुअली इट इज नॉट रूल, ये कोई रूल नहीं है, बट इट इज बेटर टेक दैट एलिमेंट विच आर प्रेजेंट मोर कंपाउंड्स आर मोर टर्म्स. तो सी आर यर हाइड्रोजन इज प्रेजेंटिंग मोर टर्म्स. तो फर्स्टली इट इज बेटर टू बैलेंस हाइड्रोजन. So see here how hydrogen can be balanced. Here 6, here 2. So I have to multiply. We have to take 3 mole of H2O. So we will multiply 3 by H2O. Then it becomes 3 to 6. See here. What we have to do? Multiply H2O by integer 3. So this equation becomes C2H6. Plus O2 is equal to CO2 3H2O. You have seen, I am multiplied by 3 in the water molecule. So what happened? This 3 into 2, here I am writing 3, I am multiplied 3 to ja, it becomes 6. And oxygen also is there, 3 into 1. What happened? Here you will see 2 plus 1 oxygen is there. So 2 plus 3 into 1. 1 is there. 3 times it becomes. So 3 plus 1, this becomes 5. So what will be the new condition? How many atoms of carbon, hydrogen and oxygen present in the equation? You can see here. This is 2. This is 1. 6. This is 6. Oxygen 2. And oxygen becomes 2 plus 3, that is 5. See here, hydrogen is balanced, but carbon is 2 and 1. If you want to balance the carbon, what we have to do? See here, we can multiply by 2 here in CO2. That time what happened? Carbon becomes also 2. So, what we have to do? Multiply CO2 in right hand side in RHS by 2. If you are multiplying, this becomes 2 carbon. What we have to do, what we have done, we have multiplied here 2 in carbon dioxide. So this reaction will become C2H6 plus O2 is equal to 2CO2 plus 3H2O. So what are changes takes place? 2 multiplied by carbon 1, that will become 2, and one more changes will be there. Here oxygen, the 2 multiplied by oxygen 2. Firstly, oxygen is here 2 multiplied by 2. So what happen here? This oxygen multiplied by 2, so this will become 2 into, see here, 2 into 2, that is 4 plus 3, it will become 7. So what will be the new position? Carbon 2, this is 2, hydrogen 6, oxygen becomes 2, and 4 plus 3, that is 4 plus 3, that is 7. Here you will see, carbon is balanced, hydrogen is balanced, still one remain, we have to balance, that is oxygen. Oxygen here 2, here 7. To see it, how can we balance the oxygen? Here 7, what do we have to do? Here 2, we have to multiply it by here, how many numbers? If you multiply it by 7 by 2, I mean 7 by 2 se multiply karo. What happened? 2 to cancel, this also becomes 7. So see here, what is in reactants 2, so that is oxygen. What we have to do? Multiply O2 by O2 in LHS by 7 by 2. What happened? C2H6, 7 by 2 O2, 2CO2, 3H2O. 7 by 2 I multiplied, 2 to cancel, that is 7. Because oxygen is separate, only one. no other changes in the other elements. That's why they become 7-7. So if you see here, carbon 2, hydrogen 6, here hydrogen 6, oxygen here 7/2 × 2 = 7, here 4 + 3 = 7. But in the reaction we are not taking this factor as a fraction. इसको हम फ्रैक्शन में नहीं रखते, इंटीजर में रखते हैं. तो इफ यू वांट टू चेंज, अदर्स विल नॉट चेंज. इफ यू वांट टू कन्वर्ट इनटू इंटीजर फॉर्म, तो व्हाट वी हैव टू डू, मल्टीप्लाई होल इक्वेशन, पूरे इक्वेशन को बेटा मल्टीप्लाई टोटल रिएक्शन LHS एंड RHS बोथ बाय 2, पूरे को 2 से मल्टीप्लाई कर दो. तो ये जो फ्रैक्शन में है दैट विल कन्वर्ट इनटू द इंटीजर फॉर्म. What happened? 2C2H6. Here 2 multiply करो बेटा 7O2. यहाँ पर क्या हो जाएगा बेटा 4CO2. And last क्या हो गया बेटा, 2 से multiply करोगे 6H2. So that we have converted into the integer form. So you can see this will be the balanced equation. अब यहाँ पर देखोगे सभी को हमने 2 से multiply कर दिया. We have multiplied by 2. फुल इक्वेशन, तो पूरे इक्वेशन को मल्टीप्लाई किया तो व्हाट हैपन, कैसे कन्वर्ट हो जाएगा बेटा, नंबर ऑफ कार्बन हियर यू विल सी 4, हियर आल्सो यू विल सी 4 × 1 = 4, 6 × 2 = 12 लेफ्ट हैंड साइड, तो राइट में भी आप देखोगे 6 × 2 = 12, और यहां पर देखोगे ऑक्सीजन 7 × 2 = 14 लेफ्ट हैंड साइड 14, तो राइट हैंड साइड 4 × 2 = 8 प्लस 6, यानी राइट हैंड साइड भी देखोगे तो 8 + 6 दैट इज आल्सो 14. तो यू विल सी 4 × 4 = 12 = 12 = 14 = 14 ऑल द एलिमेंट्स लेफ्ट हैंड साइड, नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट्स इज इक्वल टू नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट्स इन राइट हैंड साइड. ठीक, एक चीज ध्यान में देख रखना बच्चों कि यहां जैसे हमने 7/2 से मल्टीप्लाई किया तो ऑलवेज लास्टली यू कैन कन्वर्ट इन टू द फॉर्म ऑफ इंटीजर फॉर्म. यहाँ पर आप बेटर है कि आप क्या करो, लास्ट में इसे इंटीजर फॉर्म में कन्वर्ट करो, इस फॉर्म में मत रखो. इसको हम एक तरीके से और भी कर सकते हैं कि फर्स्टली मल्टीप्लाई करें 2 से, इसको 2 से मल्टीप्लाई करें, फिर से रीअरेंज करें, तो लॉन्ग प्रोसेस हो जाता है. तो बेटर है कि आप स्टार्ट में पहले इसे बैलेंस करो. अगर फ्रैक्शन फॉर्म में आ रहा है तो जो भी फ्रैक्शन है फुल इक्वेशन में उसे क्या कर दो, मल्टीप्लाई करो, तो यू कैन फाइंड द बैलेंस. इसे हम हीट एंड ट्रायल मेथड भी कहते हैं. हायर क्लास में जाओगे तो आपको ऑक्सीडेशन रिडक्शन, ऑक्सीडेशन नंबर, अदर मेथड्स आपको बताए जाएंगे, थोड़ा सा और भी कॉम्प्लिकेटेड प्रॉब्लम्स को सॉल्व करने के. तो हीट एंड ट्रायल मेथड से वी कैन बैलेंस द केमिकल इक्वेशन. सीयर बैलेंस द इक्वेशन, आई एम गिविंग यू सम क्वेश्चंस. कॉपर प्लस H2SO4, कॉपर सल्फेट एंड वाटर. तो सीयर यू हैव टू बैलेंस दीज इक्वेशंस. ये इक्वेशंस आपको बैलेंस करने हैं. कुछ और मैं क्वेश्चंस अभी दे रहा हूँ, उनको भी आप बैलेंस करो. आप इसे क्या कर सकते हैं, मेरे कमेंट बॉक्स पर भी भेज सकते हैं, या चाहे तो मेरे व्हाट्सएप नंबर पर इसे आप क्या करें, सेंड करें.